Andres and Juancarlos, you've traveled from Guatemala to come here to the Make a Makerspace conference. And why'd you do it?
Well, a couple of months ago, we started talking about having this type of spaces in Guatemala. And we started researching about it and knowing how it works and all. And we asked Google how to make a makerspace, and this came up.
We started doing some research about it and said, oh, it's a pretty big space and pretty well settled, so let's do it. Let's come here, let's
learn from the best, I guess.
Exactly.
That's great. And so why would you need a makerspace in Guatemala? What you seem to have a strongly held belief that you should have one. Why?
Yes, we both have an engineering background. Space where all that can come together.
And we've seen that there's a lot of the maker community already exists by necessity, and there's a lot of good ideas, and they probably don't know exactly how to do it, and with a little bit of guidance, they just need that jump start to start doing great things. And we think that by having this sort of communities and spaces, that they can start doing stuff that solve many of the problems. At the end, have fun and have a good space, good times.
Yeah. We're expecting this to impact the way Guatemalans think technology and the use of technology to actually accelerate our process in developing, becoming a better country, because people have hands-on experiences and they can change the way they do things today by combining technology and other disciplines.
And people are making things already in Guatemala, but why do you need a space?
Well, what we would like is that, for example, there's a lot of traditional weavers, and Guatemala is very well known for weaving clothes and whatever. But we would like to see this traditional weaver get together with an electronic guy and see something like a lily pad get sewn into a weaving, and I don't know, maybe make it into a clock, so something you can put on the wall and push a button and it shows the clock and the date. And of course that would mean it's a new business, that they can charge more for it, and they can start exporting it, make really something very unique, very interesting, and improve the way of life, make Guatemala better known internationally.
And Guatemala is very agricultural as well, and you have many people growing corn and growing coffee, and they usually have a hard time figuring out how technology can improve the crops and everything. So something as simple as automated irrigation can really become a reality if these people are in touch with geeks like us and know the electronics part of it.
So they could maybe use the same amount of water and be able to grow more food.
Exactly.
Yeah. Like, for example, Guatemala has a big problem with fungus called roya. And that roya attacks the trees that serve as shade for the coffee. And right now there's a big push into going organic. And of course, organic means...
So that means you can't use pesticides to get rid of the fungus, so you need some other way.
Exactly. So if we could get this space where we have coffee growers and expose them pollen, and they have a lot of electronic guys, mechanical guys, environmentalists, and then start thinking, okay, what way we can do to attack roya and destroy it without using pesticides, so that we can apply for the organic stuff, right? And that, of course, that means more money for the coffee and better way of life.
And a big contribution we're planning to make with this space is also this place they can go and actually have some testing equipment to check their projects is like something really would make a difference.
What has making meant for you? What has making meant for you? You're both from engineering background, so I suppose you know the book version of engineering, but you want to know the making version of it.
Well, our first experiences, I think, was not making, but destroying, because as kids, we always take toys apart and see how they were working inside. And I think that's something we shared. Into electronics and mechatronics is to actually learn what's in there and then to make stuff. And I shared with my students that it's an amazing experience when something you make or you made actually works, you know, starts doing what you said it would do.
It's like something, there's something very exciting, something that really push you along. Something, you have this idea and we use a 3D printer, we use CNC equipment or something, but there, this idea, this sketch on a piece of paper, to something you can touch, to something that people go like, oh man, this can solve a problem in my life, or, oh it's really cool, it's a piece of art, I really would like to put it on my wall, it's something very satisfying, seeing something that you can print with your hands, touch it and lit for it, and sweat for it, going to someone's life, or even your own life, and just see, yeah, you did that. Proud of your works, and it's something that you did. Yeah, we get like the side of the book side, but that complements, and that makes making things a little bit safer and a little bit faster. In the end, you have to get your hands dirty.
And that's a feeling we share with everybody here, I guess. It's just the satisfaction of having some idea be turned into a reality.